Do you know what is Power Pages or why should you learn Power Pages?
Hi, this is Priyanka from KnowHow Academy, and here let me tell you what is Power Pages. Power Pages are basically used for creating a websites, and these websites are more attractive, and these websites can be used on a regular daily basis from a small scale medium to a large scale medium. Here there is another question arise that when to use Power Pages. What is the requirements of Power Pages? Let me take one real life scenario so here you can understand when to use Power Pages. Basically, imagine you have a clothes shop and there is a shopkeeper who need to sell their clothes over the online market. From this, he need a website that increase online presence and visibility, online marketing and sales, brand promotion, showcasing products, categories of clothes like Western or we can say traditionals also. So there he need a website that can increase their sales or we can say profit to the business. To make this website, he need a developer, or we can say he need to hire a developer, and that developer can charge a high paying amount. So there is another question that why do you learn these Power Pages platform? If you are a non-technical person and don't charge any high paying amount to any developer, you can make that website by using Power Pages platform. And that Power Pages platform is a low code development, or we can say basically used for creating a website development. And this website can be mobile and responsive friendly also. This is the huge advantage we can say of the Power Pages platform. And here let me tell you how to open the Power Pages. Basically, we can search in the Google search bar Power Page login. And here you can see there is a first link, Microsoft Power Pages platform. Or we can say Microsoft Power platform. And here you can see there is a screen where we can show a trial for free, or we can also sign in. If you want to log in the Power Pages account, we need a workplace account, or we can say school email address. So here I can click for here, try it for free and enter my email address. And here I can check this box and start my free trial. And here let me enter my passwords, and if I click on sign in, it can be sign in the Power Pages platform. And here you can see this is the Power Pages platform, looks like this. And here you can see there is a home, templates, learn, solution and power platform. And here it can be show welcome Priyanka and create modern and secure business website. If you want to create a site, you can use start with a template, or we can say start from a blank. And here there is a number of environments you can see here, and there is a notification bar where we get the notify if we create any site. It can be show your site will be ready, your site exports file is ready. And here is a setting bar where you can say admin center, advanced settings, session details. We can further discuss these options. And here you can say themes. If you want to set any theme according, here you can set language and time zone. Here you can change your password. Here you can use contact preferences. And here you can get help according to the documentation, learn, support, community, and submit any idea if you need. And here it can be show my account. It can be a view account and my Microsoft 365 profile. Here you can sign out here. And if we explore these Power Pages platform, here is a templates. Here you can say it can be a number of templates. You can choose any template to design details. And the further we include, here you can say program registration, application process, FAQ, schedule and manage meetings, stair layout 1, stair layout 2, 3 and more on. Here you can say employee self-service portal, field service, modern community, order or order returns, blank, or we can say also we can create the website from a blank also. And so here there is a number of templates you can, and here we can how to learn Power Pages. Here is an overview, videos, suggested videos, suggested references, there is a tutorials, there is a design and bold.
here to use the new design studio, page workspace, how to create a page using a blank layout, move up page in the sitemap, how to create a table in the Power Pages where the records are decorated. So let me tell you about the suggested video. Here you can see create a page using a blank layout, and many more videos will be here. And here there is a solution where solutions can be used to store the websites and tables. And here you can see that we already created so many solutions. And here you can see there is a Power platform like Power Apps, Power Automate, Power BI, Power Virtual Agents, and Power Admin Center. Here, let me tell you how to create a website. So there are ways to create a website, like start with a template, or we can say start from a blank. Basically, start with a template can be used ready-made template websites, and start from a blank can are used to create a website from scratch. So here, let me tell you how to create a website with a template. Here I can choose this template and preview this template. And so here you can see there is a share layout theme 1. Here you can see a home page in a desktop, and here is a sub page 1 and sub page 2, and here is a context us page. And let me show you how this website look in a mobile. So here this is the context us page look like this, and here sub page 1 look like this. And here there is a home page look like this. So now let me choose this template and create our first website. So here let me show you how our website look in a web browser. So there is a home page, and there is a sub page 1 there, and further we have to go context us page, and let's how I'm showing you to mobile responsive. So here you can see our context page it look like this. If we move to header, there is a pages, there is a page 1, and further we have to go sub page 2, and there is a sub page 2. And if I go to home, and you can see there is a home page look like this in a mobile. So here we can see how our website look in a mobile, or we can say how our website look in a desktop. So here let me give the site name. So for example, we give this site name test website, and there is a default web address that can be show in the Google search bar when you created the website. So let me click on done, and here this website takes some time, around 15 minutes, so you can wait for a while. How your website look like this, I can show you in the browser. So here we can preview our website. So there are two options, desktop and mobile. From desktop you can see how your website look in your laptop, and a mobile you can see how your website look in a mobile. So here I click on a desktop. So here let me introduce about other pages. Here you can say access denied page, here you can say default offline page, and here you can say page not found. So let me tell you how you can edit your header. So where we click on edit site header, here we can change the site name, or we can say company name of the website. So let me take the example Myntra. So here you can say that I can change their name of the site. So you can see the changes here also. So whenever you do any changes in the website, you can first sync here, and then you can preview your website. So let me tell you how you can see these changes on the browser also. So let me preview this page first. So here you can see the company title name also change here. So here next I have to show you how you can change the company logo. So let me go here, and I can upload one image, so you can show that. Here we can change the company logo image. So I can select this image and I can upload here. Okay, then here you can say it can be uploading images. I can select this and I can click OK, and I can cross this, and here you can say that can already our logo image show, can be shown here. We can click on sync. It can be saved our changes that can be done in the website, or we can say that the changes that can be done in a home page. So we can click on our desktop, and here we can preview our changes here. So here you can see that can be a logo can be shown here. Here alt text can be used when our images will not be uploaded, and let style our header also. There you can see brand colors like blue, orange, white, black. Here you can change the header color like orange, and we can say white, or we can say black also. So let's see the changes of these. So first we can sync these changes to see in the website. So it takes some time to save the changes, and then we can preview this website in the web browser. So you can see the changes here. It can be a black color. So here you can see that how these can be changes done. So let me tell you how you can change the font also of the header title. So there you can say Arial and others also font. So you can change only by clicking. And here you can say weight, regular, or we can say semi bold, and we can say bold. Here you can say save the changes of the title to small or big on the bigger. And that can be done. Here you can say the color also like black, it can be disappear. You can see if we set orange, you can see the changes in the site also. So let me sync these changes first to show these changes in the website. I already told you that these changes take time to preview. Let's preview these changes in the website. So here you can see the changes of the Myntra. So this is the changes of the font, weight and size. So here let me tell you about site navigation. Basically, site navigation will include home, pages, contacts, us. So let me show you that how you can change the font. So let me click on this, and how you can change the weight like light, regular, semi bold, and we can say bold. And here you can change the font size. Let me choose 24. Here you can see the changes. Let me choose 9. So here you can see the changes. Let me click on 15, and here you can just see the changes. And here you can change the color. So we can click on blue, or we can choose the orange. So here you can see the changes. So let me cross this first, and we can see the changes of the website. So it takes time, and let me preview this also to see the changes in the web browser. So here you can see the changes here. So here let me tell you about on hover style. Here you can set two options, no underline and underline, and here you can change the color also. So let me show you what is underline and non-underline. When you click in on these options, here you can see underline under the pages over the answer page 1, it also show underline, and another home, contact us also show underline. If you want to disable this underline, so we can go here, and you can choose this no underline, and here you can choose the color also like white. So we can cross this first and save the changes that we can done in this website. So let me preview this to see the changes in the web browser. So here you can see that we can hover these site navigation home pages. So it can be show white in color, and it does not show any underline. So let me tell you about further on layout. So layout is basically increase the size, or we can say decrease the size of the websites. Thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you navigate the tech world. If you have any question, don't hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. So stay curious and keep learning.